While Governor Christie makes a spirited defense of his ability to govern, scandals notwithstanding, Republicans criticize the investigation into the controversial lane closures on the George Washington Bridge, especially the governor's helicopter ride.
We were stunned because it was never discussed.
Assemblywoman Holly Schapese is one of four Republicans on the Joint Committee probing the scandal. A log of Christie's chopper flights that first week of September is among 18 additional subpoenas issued yesterday, on top of the original 20.
So him merely being in a helicopter on 9/11, I don't personally believe proves anything. Our concern was, well, why are we jumping the gun and issuing a whole new slew of subpoenas when we don't yet have the information that we have originally requested?
The new subpoenas include some repeats, the governor's office and his reelection campaign, and Bill Baroni, former deputy executive director appointed by Christie to the Port Authority, who later resigned when the scandal broke. The list also includes several additional Port Authority officials and assistants to Baroni and David Wildstein.
Executive assistants sometimes are the ones who do the emails or write the letters or the notes or the phone logs.
Committee co-chair Senator Loretta Weinberg says the second round of subpoenas also targets Port Authority Commissioner Pat Schuber. Weinberg had written him a letter asking about the lane closures.
Commissioner Schuber did call me, and he did say he was, and I'm quoting him pretty directly, "I'm going to get to the bottom of this." And it is now almost 5 months later.
Concerning Christie's helicopter trip, state police issued a statement today noting none of the three flights transporting the governor during that week flew over or close to either the George Washington Bridge or Fort Lee, including the flight on 9/11. New Jerseyans can expect to see more fireworks in the matter. A battery of high-octane attorneys hired by some of the subpoenaed subjects say they plan to fight it out in court before they surrender those subpoenaed documents. In Alpine, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJTV News.